Have you ever wanted to make an LED chaser circuit like the ones in cool gadgets and cars? Hey guys, in this video, I'll show you how to make an LED chaser circuit using the 555 timer and CD4017. Stay tuned to the second part of this video, where I'll explain how this circuit works. Here are all the components you need to set up this circuit. 19 jumper wires, 10 LEDs, any color will do, a 1 microfarad capacitor, 147,000 ohms resistor, 1,000 ohm resistor, 1,470 ohms resistor, 1555 timer IC, 1 CD4017 IC, a battery holder with 4 AA batteries for the power source, a breadboard to connect everything together. The 555 timer IC comes with 8 pins. There is a notch or a dot on the chip's body. Pin 1, located at the top left, serves as the ground or ground supply. Pin 2, the trigger pin, initiates the timing interval in monostable and astable modes. Pin 3 serves as the output, providing the timer's operational result depending on its mode: monostable, astable, or bistable. Pin 4, the reset pin, is used to reset the 555 timer's internal flip-flop. Pin 5 serves as the control pin, enabling you to adjust the threshold voltage levels used by the internal comparators to set and reset the flip-flop. Pin 6, the threshold pin, monitors the voltage of the capacitor in the circuit. Pin 7, the discharge pin, manages the timing capacitor's charge and discharge cycle. Pin 8, known as VCC, supplies power to the IC. Let's set up the circuit step by step. Begin by positioning the 555 timer IC on the breadboard. The pins are numbered counterclockwise, starting from the top left corner. Refer to the later circuit diagram if you have questions about the circuit connections. Insert the 555 timer in the middle of the breadboard. A jumper wire connects pin 1 or ground to the negative rail. A jumper wire connects pin 8 or VCC to the positive rail. Use a jumper wire to connect pin 2 or trigger to pin 6 or threshold. Use a jumper wire to connect pin 4 or reset to pin 8 or VCC. Insert a 1 microfarad capacitor into pin 2 or trigger and the negative rail. Insert the shorter leg into the negative rail. Bend the ends of a 47,000 ohms resistor. Insert the 47,000 ohms resistor to pin 2 or trigger and pin 7 or discharge. Bend the ends of a 1,000 ohms resistor. Insert the 1,000 ohms resistor to pin 7 or discharge and the positive rail. The notch or dot of the CD4017 should be at the top. Insert the 4017 below the 555 timer. Use a jumper wire to connect pin 8 of the IC to the negative rail. Use a jumper wire to connect pin 16 of the IC to the positive rail. Use a jumper wire to connect pin 8 to pin 13. Use a jumper wire to connect pin 8 to pin 15. Use a jumper wire to connect pin 3 or output of the 555 to pin 14 or clock input of the 4017. Bend the ends of a 470 ohms resistor. Insert the 470 ohm resistor into the negative rail, which connects the negative terminals of all the LEDs. Use a jumper wire to connect pin 3 of the IC to the first LED. Insert one leg of the LED in the same row as the jumper wire and the other in the negative rail. Insert the shorter leg in the negative rail. Use a jumper wire to connect pin 2 of the IC to the second LED. Make sure the cathode of each LED is connected to the negative rail. Connect pin 4 to the third LED. Connect pin 7 to the fourth LED. Connect pin 10 to the fifth LED. Connect pin 1 to the 6th LED. Connect pin 5 to the 7th LED. Connect pin 6 to the 8th LED. Connect pin 9 to the 9th LED. Finally, connect pin 11 to the 10th LED. Here's a different angle showing all the jumper wire connections. It's time to connect the power supply. Attach the negative lead from the battery holder to the negative rail. Attach the positive lead from the battery holder to the positive rail. We have successfully completed the circuit. The LED chaser creates a captivating visual effect. Let's dive into the circuit and break it down step by step. The 555 timer is configured in a stable mode, acting as a clock generator. The 47,000 and 1,000 ohms resistors set the charging and discharging time. The 1 microfarad capacitor determines the oscillation frequency or the blinking speed. The 555 generates a repeating on-off signal at its output or pin 3. This type of signal is called a square wave because it switches between high voltage, on, and low voltage, off, at regular intervals. This square wave signal acts as a clock pulse, an electrical signal that tells other components when to operate. The clock pulse is sent to pin 14 or clock of the CD4017. The CD4017 is a decade counter that sequentially activates one of its 10 outputs, Q0 to Q9, each time it receives a clock pulse from the 555. Whenever this pulse goes from low to high or off to on, the CD4017 moves to the following output, or Q0 to Q9. The LEDs are connected to the outputs Q0 to Q9, turning on sequentially in a running light effect. Each LED is connected in series with a 470 ohms resistor to prevent excessive current. Pin 15 is connected to ground to allow the counter to cycle through all outputs before resetting. Pin 13 is also connected to ground to keep the counter active. To slow down or speed up the LED chaser effect, adjust the 47,000 or 1,000 ohms resistor, or the 1 microfarad capacitor. I hope this video has shown you how to make an LED chaser circuit with a 555 timer and a CD4017. If you found this video helpful, give it a thumbs up, consider subscribing for more electronics tips and tutorials, and hit the bell icon to never miss an update. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.